Today we'll discuss about the effect of dielectric on capacitance. Consider a dielectric inserted between the plates fully occupying the intervening region. You see, there are two plates of the parallel plate capacitor, and the region between the two plates is fully occupied by the dielectric. This is the positive charged plate of the parallel plate capacitor, and this is the negatively charged plate. The dielectric is polarized by the external field. Suppose you give a external field E0, apply external field, let us say E0, as a result of which the dielectric will be polarized. To know how a dielectric is polarized in the presence of electric field, you refer the video Dielectrics and Polarization. Suppose by the application of field, the surface charge density is sigma p and minus sigma p. On the side of the positive charge plate, the surface charge density due to the polarization of the dielectric is minus sigma p, and on the negatively charged plate, the surface density of charge is plus sigma p. The net surface density of charge will be sigma minus sigma p, and here on this side it will be equal to minus sigma plus sigma p. So if you take minus common, it will be minus sigma minus sigma p. Remember, here plus and minus is due to, gives you the direction of the field, is due to the direction of the field, but the net charge, surface density of charge, magnitude of the surface density of charge is sigma minus sigma p. We know the electric field due to an infinitely long charged plane sheet is equal to E is equal to sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. We have proved this is nothing but the application of the Gauss law. We have proved it in a separate video in the application of Gauss law. Now this parallel plate capacitor have three regions. This is region 1, this is region 2, and this is region 3. In between the two parallel plates, this is region 3. In region 1, the field is equal to 0. In region 2, the field is equal to 0. And in region 3, the field will be equal to sigma minus sigma p divided by epsilon 0. And for detailed analysis, you refer the video of parallel plate capacitor. How the electric field in outer region 1 and 2 equal to 0. And how the electric field between the inner region, in a region between the plates, E equal to sigma minus sigma p divided by epsilon 0. Now, you remember, when a dielectric is introduced, the free charge on the plates remains the same. When you apply the electric field, the free charge on the plates remains the same, but the potential between the plates will decrease. Okay, when electric field is applied, the free charge on this plate will remain same, but the potential in between the plates will decrease. And we know the potential difference across the plates, V equal to the product of electric field and the plate separation. And electric field is equal to the charge density divided by epsilon 0. Is not it? We have proved it how the electric field at the surface of a charged conductor E is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the surface density of charge in the video of electrostatics of conductors. And we know for linear dielectrics, the induced charge density is directly proportional to the applied field. Previously we have seen that the induced charge density, that is proportional to the applied field. And the electric field is equal to the surface density of charge divided by epsilon 0, is not it? Sigma p is proportional to E0 and E0 is equal to sigma divided by epsilon 0. So sigma p, that is the induced charge density, will be proportional to the surface charge density. That is, when external field is applied, sigma increases and sigma p also increases, such that the value sigma proportional to sigma minus sigma p. This is very important. The value sigma, surface charge density, is proportional to the resultant charge density, sigma minus sigma p. So sigma will be equal to k into sigma minus sigma p, where k is a constant, and this constant depends upon the characteristics of the dielectric material. So k will be always greater than 1. Remember, k is always greater than 1. So the potential V will be equal to sigma minus sigma p divided by epsilon 0 into d. But sigma minus sigma p is equal to sigma divided by k. So if you substitute sigma by k here, it will be sigma d divided by epsilon 0 k. But sigma is equal to q by a, charge by area. So charge by area into d divided by epsilon 0 k. But c is equal to q by v. So c will be equal to q divided by v, this amount. So it will be equal to epsilon 0 k a by d. So this gives the expression for capacitance of a capacitor in the presence of dielectric. And what is permittivity? In this expression, epsilon 0 k, the product epsilon 0 k is called the permittivity of the medium. And epsilon 0 k is equal to epsilon, which is nothing but the permittivity of the medium. And for vacuum, k value is equal to 1. Okay, for medium epsilon 0, k is equal to epsilon. But for vacuum, k is equal to 1. So epsilon is equal to epsilon 0. And here epsilon 0 is called permittivity of the vacuum. Now from this equation, epsilon 0 k is equal to epsilon, k will be equal to epsilon divided by epsilon 0. It is called the dielectric constant of the substance. So dielectric constant is a dimensionless ratio. Remember, it is a dimensionless ratio. Since value of k is always greater than 1, so epsilon is always greater than epsilon 0. Okay. Then in vacuum, the capacitance C0 is equal to epsilon 0 A by D. But in a dielectric medium, C is equal to epsilon 0 K A by D. So if you take the ratio C divided by C0, you will get K. So this is the definition of the dielectric constant. And this relation holds good for any type of capacitor. Okay. Since K is greater than 1, C is always greater than C0. So in summary, when a dielectric is introduced in between the parallel plates of a capacitor, the capacitance of the capacitor increases. The charge on the two plates remains same, but charge means the free charge. The free charge remains the same, but the effective charge that changes. Okay, free charge, that means the free charge density sigma. Sigma remains same, but the effective charge sigma minus sigma p changes. Okay, and the another thing is the potential varies. The potential between the two plates varies. In the next video, we will discuss about electric displacement. Thank you.